And now we will receive payments for the invoices that we just made. Receiving payments for invoices will change two areas of our accounting records. Of course, every transaction that is a transaction affects the general ledger, and the results eventually change the trial balance. And we will predict what the results will be before we record the transaction. But of course, if we are receiving payments from customers, that very same payment will also affect the customer records. For example, let's imagine on January 9, we received $3,000 from Alan for the January 1 invoice. Let's also imagine the money was directly deposited into the bank account. Now, I know it's not always done this way, but for now, we're going to imagine that any payment we receive is directly deposited into the bank account, and the other situations where we're handed a check or handed cash or given a credit card swipe, those situations will be learned about at the end of this course in the banking section. But for now, let's imagine the money that we received from Alan was directly deposited into the bank account. Now, what will happen in the trial balance? Well, here we are in our QuickBooks Online account, and if you click Reports, My Custom Report, and you open the trial balance, before we record this payment, accounts receivable is $21,820. However, we are getting paid $3,000. So can you predict what will happen to accounts receivable if we receive $3,000 of money owed to us by a customer? Well, that's right. Accounts receivable will go down by the $3,000 because it represents how much is owed. So if we get paid, they owe us less. Accounts receivable will become $18,820. So after we record this payment, we're going to double check the trial balance to make sure that we see it has become the correct number. Cash in bank shows up for the first time as $3,000. Right now, cash in bank is not on the trial balance at all. But after we record that we received $3,000 in cash, $3,000 will show up here in the trial balance for cash in bank. To record receiving a payment, click the plus sign, then go over to the customer area under the plus sign and choose Receive Payment. It's right under the invoice that you made that you're receiving the payment for. So go ahead and click on it. Now, we choose from the top left which customer we're receiving from, in this case, Alan. And look what happens to the screen when we choose Alan. All of Alan's open invoices appear. In fact, I'm going to modify this so it fits into the video screen. Okay. Now, if we scroll down, you can see these are three of the invoices that we made that we made for Alan that he hasn't paid yet. So you might have to scroll up and down a little to see them. You should also put the date. The date that we got paid was January 9. Of course, if it were a direct deposit into Cash and Chase Bank, you would have some long, weird number to record. Let's just put 1111111 just so that there's some reference number whenever there's a direct deposit. Now, if the payment method were check, then this would be the check number, okay? But we're going to leave payment method blank because it was a direct deposit into the bank account. So we have the who, we have the when, and we have where it's going. Now we need to put how much. So Alan gave us $3,000, and as usual, to save just a field without saving the whole window, push the tab key. Now, QuickBooks automatically finds the match, and it matched the amount of the payment to the amount of the invoice, and in this case, it's correct. So all we have to do is either click Save and New, or we could choose Save and Close, and the transaction is recorded. Now, when we come back to our good friend, the trial balance, are the numbers what we expected? Yes, they are. Cash and Chase Bank showed up for the first time as 3,000, and accounts receivable decreased to exactly the amount we expected, 18,820. Now, as I mentioned a moment ago, the trial balance and the general ledger in the chart of accounts is not the only place affected by the customer transactions. From this very same received payment, the customer records are also different. So, if we open up the reports, and of course the default is already set to My Custom Reports, is very convenient, we can look at the customer balance detail and look at the section of Allen. If we scroll down, you can see that Allen now only owes us $6,000. And you may also notice that the invoice has disappeared. Invoice number one for January 1 has disappeared from the customer balance detail report. To fully understand this, let's take a look at a second example. Let's imagine on January 10, we received $680 from Betty, specifically for the January 4 invoice. Now, if we look at the customer balance detail for Betty, you can see here's January 4. She really owes us $1,680. So that means if we receive only $680 from Betty, that means that after we receive this payment, when we come back to this report, this invoice for January 4th will be $1,000 even. But it'll also affect, oh, by the way, we're also imagining the money was directly deposited into the bank account. And of course, we will review situations where you get handed a check, cash, or credit card swipe. We'll review those situations when we do the banking section later. But what will happen to the trial balance if we received $680? Well, accounts receivable goes down by 680, and it will become 18,140. So right now, if you go back to reports and you open the trial balance, you can see that it's 18,820. But if we receive 680, it will go down to 18,140 after we record this transaction. Cash in bank becomes 3,680. Why? Because cash in bank is 3,000 now, and if we get $680 more, it becomes 3,680. So let's record this transaction. Again, you go to the plus sign, and you click Receive Payment, and this time you received the payment from Betty Boop. And this time the date was January 10. It goes into the cash in bank account, and we're going to do a banking section later. The amount we received was 680, and in order to save the field, we push the tab key. Now, QuickBooks assumes that we are receiving the payments in date order, so QuickBooks automatically click the check mark here next to this invoice and put the payment here. What you need to do is first remove the check mark by clicking on it, then click the check mark on the specific invoice that's being paid. Again, you can't just click here. If you do, you're applying payments more than you received. So you have to be very careful. The amount that you physically received up here has to be the same as the totals down here as what you apply. So you leave the amount that you got up here and then you check to apply it here. Now, when we click Save and Close and go back to the customer records, the January 4th invoice will be $1,000 even. Save and Close. And of course, well, by the way, the trial balance is correct. Cash in bank went up to 3,680, and accounts receivable went down to 18,140, exactly the numbers we predicted. But then, if we open up our custom reports, and we go to the customer balance detail, you can see for Betty Boop that this was the original amount, and this is the amount open balance. This is the amount remaining unpaid. And of course, Betty's overall balance decreased by 680, and Betty owes us 680 less, but specifically this invoice decreased and is now only $1,000. Applying customers' payments and fixing misapplied payments can be very tricky. That's why I recommend you watch the desktop videos for those topics. So I suggest you watch the desktop videos that I created for applying customers' payments, fixing misapplied payments, and you can watch them on this very website that you're watching this video from now. The course is called Customers and Advanced Receivables, and you can learn anything about managing customer-related transactions or data related to customers from this advanced course, and it will apply to QuickBooks Online.